probably one of the biggest albums of the year, and that was the MTV Unplugged by Nirvana, another group showing a completely different side of themselves with an album. And this, I don't remember this, but this came out after Kurt Cobain died.
Oh, I remember. Oh, absolutely. That's why it was so huge. It was like what, 2-3 months after he died, he came out?
It was like right around the holiday. I think the beginning of the holiday season, it came out.
What was great about the Nirvana one, you know, they showed them a different side. You think they were just a one-trick pony kind of thing. And here they were doing Lead Belly songs, just songs that you think you would never hear acoustically by Nirvana. They covered that Bowie song. That was huge.
We did a whole show with the Warden on MTV Unplugged, and just how I was talking to somebody at work about this the other day, just how important, like, culturally in the music MTV Unplugged was, right? To get to see this band doing something totally different.
Yeah, in a cool setting. You know, it's brilliant, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's play a little bit of The Man Who Sold the World.
I spoke into his eyes, I thought you died
Wow. I remember coming out, and then at the end of the song, he goes, "That was a David Bowie song." And it, like, rocket shit. Like, you know, it was a huge success.
He was only in the music scene for 3 years, right? He dies at Nevermind came out in 91, and he died in 94. And just how such a huge impact his music had to everybody our age. I mean, I know you're not a huge Nirvana fan, but, you know, in general.
But I respect what he did. You know, his songwriting skills are fucking amazing. That to write this song in a pop way, it's brilliant. It just wasn't my thing.
That's fair.
I have it on vinyl. It's one of my favorite vinyls to listen to now.
The MTV but Unplugged?
Never mind. I'm sorry. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but I got you.
I would like to have that on vinyl, Unplugged. That would be bad. I'm going to look that up.